Allow me to introduce myself. My name is China Horton Olighton. Welcome, my kings and queens, to the One in a Million show, where you are encouraged to stand out and become the best version of yourself through Christ. Please tune in every Saturday at 2:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on WCVG 1320 a.m. And remember, with God, all things are possible. Hello, welcome my kings and queens to the One in a Million show. I'm so happy to share a portion of my Saturday with you all. And if you are watching via Facebook, then you already see what today's topic is. And today's topic is, it's never too early to start a new thing. Once again, it's never too early to start a new thing. So let's even just get familiar with what the word new means. I'm pretty sure we know what it means, but let's just get a little refresher, right? So it means not existing before, made, introduced, or discovered recently, or now for the first time. So I know that 2021 is coming, right? We get excited. It's a new year. And a lot of times I hear, you know, new year, new me, new year resolutions. You know, people set goals. They set all type of stuff, just different things that they want to do, you know, major changes. You know, people always speak like that when a new year happens. And if you are one of those type of people that, you know, wait to the new year to do something different in your life or want to try something new, hey, that's totally your prerogative. If that's the way you like to do things, then that's totally fine. But in today's message, what I want to stress is, when God is telling you to do something, there's no time in it. God operates outside of time. So if God is telling you to do something and he's telling you like right now, and it's before the new year, a little bit after the new year, middle of the new year, whatever. If God is telling you to do it, then go ahead and do it immediately without any hesitations. I want to give you all a quick, I'm going to give you a quick testimony and then we're going to get into the word. So if you knew me back in 2017, then you know your girl was, you know, overweight. I was overweight. I was almost 300 pounds. Yes, I was almost 300 pounds back in 2017. God was tugging at me for a long time about my weight, but it was just something that I didn't want to do it, if I can be honest. Like, my flesh didn't want to do it. I physically didn't want to do it. Again, we talking about close to 300 pounds. You know, physical activity was the last thing in my mind. But I remember, like, yesterday, February 2017, I woke up one day, I went to the mirror, I was disgusted. I was disgusted with myself. You know, I let myself go. I was young, still young, and, you know, my body wasn't up to par. I didn't feel, you know, healthy, and, you know, not to mention, you know, certain health problems, you know, running my family, diabetes, high blood pressure, those type of things running my family. So, you know, I wasn't exempt from getting that type of stuff if I didn't make a major change. Now, I remember, you know how most times, like I said in the beginning of the live, I said that sometimes we wait till New Year's, like, oh, I'm going to do it Monday, January 1st. That's changed my life. I remember back in 2017, again, it was February. I didn't start on a Monday. I remember it was a Thursday. I woke up that day and I changed my life for the good because I was tired. I got to a place where I was uncomfortable in my own skin. And then, most importantly, it was God. He was showing me so many messages through people, through my doctor, through just different things, showing me that I needed to get this weight off. And secretly, you know, dealing with this battle with food, you know, it was something hard to deal with. You know, my doctor telling me, hey, China, it's really time to lose weight. You know, I'm keeping this stuff to myself. I'm like, she's like, you need to start doing some physical activity or something because, like I said, I was close to 300 pounds and I was 276 pounds to be exact. But anyway, again, going back to this message, I just want to encourage anybody who's about to make any new changes or anything that they feel that God is telling them, you do not have to wait until a new year. You don't have to wait. If God is telling you to do something now, it's not 2021 yet. If he's telling you to do that very thing right now, go and do it. So going back to my story, you know, when God tells you to do something, it may seem like out of the ordinary to other people from the outside looking in. You know, when I went on my weight loss journey, there was people like, oh, you don't need to lose weight. You're fine just the way you are. You're beautiful. Oh, bigness running our family. You may be like, you're going to hear all type of stuff, whatever type of goal it is. And this is not just weight loss. I'm just giving an example of my personal story. So when I did that, you know, there was times I had to discipline myself. I had to not go out to eat with friends because, like, I'm on this journey. I had to have tunnel vision. I can't eat that. I can't always, you know, go on certain outings because I know I'm going to be tempted with certain things. I had to make a major change. And I know sometimes when you're doing a certain goal, and again, not just like weight loss, some people around you be like, oh, it don't take all that. You don't have to do all of that. You don't have to do all that. Yes, it does. It requires discipline. Whatever goal you have, and if God telling you to do it, it requires discipline. God may tell you to step away from some friends. He may tell you to stop going certain places. He might tell you to do some things that looks unordinary even to you. But if God is telling you to do it, you do that thing. Because one thing about God is, if he's telling us something, he's telling us for our own good. He's telling us for the benefit of our lives. He's telling us because there is destiny, there is favor, there is something that he's trying to show us through this journey. So even while I was going through this health journey and people were looking at me like I'm crazy, even in my own family, for making such a drastic change in my life, people didn't agree with it. People talked about me. I still did it because I knew that God, he had something in this. Even though it was just dealing with health, God had something in this for me to see. And out of that, I seen a healthier China. What if I didn't listen to God's voice at that time? What if I didn't? I could be on diabetic medication right now. I could be on high blood pressure medication right now. Who knows what could have happened if I didn't listen to the voice of God at this time? And that's why when I speak about this message today, you're going to see how serious it is. If God is telling you something, you don't have to wait to a specific time. If he's telling you to do it right then and there, he's telling you to start that business, he's telling you to go ahead and cut those people off, he's telling you to go ahead and leave that job, do it. Don't even hesitate. If you know it's truly coming from God, if you know it's truly coming from God, go ahead and do it. If, look, this is the way to think about it. If God gave you your life, right, why not trust him with it? If he gave you your life, why not trust him with it? So if God was speaking to me, what everyone else was saying around me, it went through one ear out the other. God is telling me to do this for me. He's telling me to do this for me. So I don't know what God is telling you at this moment. I don't know what it is that you're dealing with. I don't know what God is telling you, like, hey, you need, it's time. Don't wait till January 1st, 2021. If he said do it today, do it today. If he said did it yesterday, I hope you did it yesterday. So we're going to go into some scripture now because I want to talk about a specific person in the Bible who also didn't operate in time. He operated with the commands of God, and that specific person is Noah. So we're going to journey through this real quick. Genesis 6, verse 11 through 22, and we're going to take a look at this scripture, and I want to point some things out to you guys, and hopefully you all can learn from this and, you know, take something from it and know that, look, don't go off your time. I'm telling you, when God is telling you to do something, you do that thing. So let's go ahead and start again. I'm starting at Genesis 6, verse 11 through 22. And it says, now the earth was corrupt in God's sight, and the earth was filled with violence. And God saw the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted their way on the earth. And God said to Noah, I have determined to make an end of all flesh, for the earth is filled with violence through them. Behold, I will destroy them with the earth. Make yourself an ark of gopher wood. Make rooms in the ark and cover it inside without pitch. This is how you are to make it. The length of the ark, 300 cubits, its breadth 50 cubits, and its height 30 cubits. Make a roof for the ark and finish it to a cubit above and set the door of the ark in its side. Make it with lower, second, and third decks. For behold, I will bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh in which it is the breath of life under heaven. Everything that is on earth shall die, but I will establish my covenant with you, and you shall come into the ark. You, your sons, your wife, your sons' wives with you. And of every living thing of all flesh, you shall bring two of every sort in the ark to keep them alive with you. They shall be male and female. Of the birds according to their kinds, and of the animals according to their kinds, of every creeping things up, and every creepy thing of the ground according to its kind, two of every sort shall come into you to keep them alive. Also take with you every sort of food that is eaten and store it up. It shall serve as food for you and for them. Noah did this. He did all that God commanded him. What is the purpose of this? Okay, so if you read the book of Genesis and you read the story with Noah, you already know that if you think back in those times when Noah was told to make this ark, right? I mean, at this time, God told him, like, I need you to make this ark. I'm about to flood the earth out. People are going to be dying, but I'm going to keep you and your family. This is basically what he's saying. I'm breaking it down in layman's terms. So if you think about in that time, think about the people that was around Noah. They probably was looking at him like he is crazy because he's hearing from God. And again, think of the timing. People are wondering, like, why is this dude building an ark in the middle of nowhere? Like, what is he doing? He looked crazy. That's the same things that happen when God tells you a specific thing. Everybody else around you is going to be looking like, what are they doing? If you got a specific goal, is there something that you want to do? Let's say you want to run a business, right? And your family know you don't really have no money. But God is telling you to run this business because he's the one that's going to finance you. You go ahead and do it because everybody's going to be looking crazy. Everybody's going to look, how is she doing this? How is she about to run this business? How is this man about to run this t-shirt business in the middle of a pandemic? But just like Noah, he heard from God. So it didn't matter how it looked. It didn't matter the time or the season that he was in. He heard from God. And the thing that I really admire about this story is you never heard once Noah hesitating when God told him to do it. He didn't say, but why God, I don't see any rain right now. But why God, I don't see any floods right now. God, why are you telling me to do this? I don't understand. It don't make sense to me. Why should I do it? You know, and again, going back to my weight loss journey, you know, it didn't feel comfortable to me at that time when God told me, today you stop eating junk food. Today, it was in the middle of the week, almost in today, you stop today, no more overeating, no more going in the middle of the night, going to White Castle, you stop right now. It didn't make sense to me. I'm like, well, why out of all days, I'm so serious about it now? Because when God is telling you something at a specific time, and he's telling you to do it, do it. Do it. Don't ask questions. Don't have, but you know what about us humans? It's normal for us to question things because we're human, right? It's normal for us to question things. So God, he's going to expect us to ask like, well, you know, hey God, you know, why I have to do this? And that's normal. But what I'm saying is if you're hearing from God, it is okay to just go ahead and accept it because you know that whatever he's asking you of and whatever he's telling you to do is for your good. It's for your good. So I like I said, I don't know what it is, that thing that you are dealing with, that thing that God has been tugging with you on. Even those who have been struggling to start that relationship with Christ, go ahead and start it. There's going to be some people that look at you funny. There's going to be some people that be like, oh, you're reading the word now? Oh, you going to church now? Forget it. Tunnel vision. If God is pulling at your heart, if God is tugging at you right now to make a change in your life, if God is telling you my word is true, I need you to hear it for myself. I know you've been abused at other churches. I know you ain't had the best experience in churches, but I'm telling you right now to develop the relationship with me. Do not hesitate. Like I said, if God is telling you to truly do something, he's telling you to do something. It's for your good. Tunnel everybody else out. Tunnel everybody else out. His time is perfect. And there's one more thing I wanted to add too. When I read this, because I've read this story multiple times, one thing I noticed with Noah is every time in the text it said, I put this in my notes. What did he say? It mentioned several times that Noah did as God commanded. Noah did as God commanded. I've seen that a lot in there. It's like he didn't. whatever God told him to do, he just did it. He just did it. And that's what we have to do with our lives. So again, I don't know what it is that God has been tugging with you, what God has, what you've been wrestling with. And he's been telling you to do it right now. Do it. But I do have some advice of the day. I know my time goes so fast. I do have some advice for today. The advice for today is, again, it's never too early to do what God is telling you to do, because when he tells you to do it, it is the perfect timing. God bless you all. I will see you next Saturday. Enjoy your weekend.